to remember that there were times of other plagues, of famine, of crusades, of pogroms, of genocide, of war, times where whole families were taken with no one left to say Kaddish for them. When loved ones would disappear and we would not know when they died, we needed to have a time where we would remember them. The dark side of human history took so many and continues to take so many as we remember that each life, each and every life, is a whole world. Yizkor is a service and a prayer to remember and name those upon whose shoulders we stand, whose names we are called to whisper to us from the past.
Not only this expert, national, really international expert.
Could someone please mute the people who are, thank you. So, oh, life is imperfect. Everything is imperfect. And it is up to us to just respond in the holiest of ways.
Rabbi Susan, I'm sorry, if you could unmute yourself.
Yeah.
Okay, can you hear us now? Okay, we're back. So, I know that this is a tender time. You know, for us, we're so busy. There's so many things that fill our days, right? And so we made this Yizkor service so that we would have this space, right? Space that wasn't going to be filled with anything else other than our grief. Space that wouldn't be filled with anything else other than the names of the people that we must remember. And so, as I said, there were times in the darkest times of our history, other plagues, wars, crusades, pogroms. There were other times in our history where people would die and we wouldn't know when. Sometimes we wouldn't even know where. Sometimes it would be whole families that would be taken and no one left to say Kaddish for them. And so we instituted these four Yizkor services, one of them on the afternoon of Yom Kippur, to make a space for our mourning, to make a space for us, to not have to think about anything else other than our loved ones and our grief. Oops, we lost. No, not yet. 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 Okay. Could you put us back on? Can we go back on? There we go. Okay. In just a moment, we are going to have, as we always do, some beautiful music, this time again from Chava Polinsky. And on the screen, you'll be able to see all of the names. But first, I'm going to read some of the names that may not have gone up on the screen. Some of the names that of the people who have died in this past year that may not have made it into our book of life. We won't have all the names this year. I haven't been there to receive your notes, but you have the names. You hold them. And so first, let's say some of the prayers And then we'll be ready to say and to see and to remember the names of our loved ones.
Yizkor, the memory of a friend or family, the memory of a birthright, my parents' childhood home, first school, the library, I remember. Their old age, a vacation in the summer, a lunch at the beach, the card games. Their friends at dinner, their laughter, how they cried when their parents died, the memory of our house. The memories of their parents, immigrants, a shop in the city, golden in Medina, school, a job, a home, children. I remember the memories of my parents, of their parents, I remember. The memories of my great-grandparents huddling in a corner of a cold room in Ukraine, Minsk, Belarus, Vilna, in Salonika, Casablanca, Kyiv, Baghdad, Kishinev. I remember them hiding their children under a table in a cellar. My great-grandparents praying for the lives of their children. A broken leaf of a table. The candlelight, the holy books, the sacred intent of our lives. While they howled in the street, we huddled together for warmth around a fire, reading our holy books and teaching our children. In a world without sense, we made sense. I remember it all.
Yizkor Elohim Nishmot Yakire. May God remember forever the souls of our dear ones who have gone to their eternal rest. May they be at one with the one who is eternal life. May the beauty of their lives shine forevermore, and may our lives always bring honor to their memory. And so we remember. Rita Balk, Susan Silver, Robert Wofsy and Aaron Corson, Donald Simmons Sr., John Isaacs, Sanford Goldman, Sandy Richter, Carol Gerstein and Joseph Sherman, Joe, Laverne Emanuel, Ethel Schwartz, Harriet Sechter and Betty Oberman, Suzanne Glazer and Pat Dewey, Melvin Lester and Julie Eichen, Estelle Handler and Charles Allen, Richard Priest and Leonard Kaminer, Evie Goldberg, Tom Trieger, Marilyn Corley and Alexander Dane, Bruce Rosen, Dr. Elliot Gelman, Robert Temko and Monty Ross, Debbie Siegel and Lily Kotsky, Ann Erke, Claire Hyman, Mo Billy, Ruth Friedman and Albert Tota, John Kepler, Dolores Silverberg, Alan Wolman, Bonnie Hunman, Tom Gilbert, Alan Goldman, Jackie Pultman, Sandy Feinstein, Donald Holtzman, Lou Osheroff, Bonnie Levins, Aaliyah Light, Shirley Sewell, Gil Nussbaum, Harvey Weiss, Lily Atkinson, Molly Frolickstein, Fran Hyman, Libby Greenbaum, Marvin Kotsky, Ann Schifrin, Jan Nelson, Kent Huffman, Charlotte Futterman, Norman Roth, Sidney Feiner, Jerome Schneider, Betty Gershman, Charlene Schneider, Edward Berg, Donna Levitz, Claire Kroll, Jerry Brown, Stan Zerman, Rich Amaker, Buddy Glassman, Emily Weiss, Rodney Barton, Vern Benjamin, Norton Cronimer, Orna Knitzen, Henry Couric, and the baby Jude Eli Anton McCarty. Andrew Davis, Jack Coran, Professor Steve Glickman, Erica Lissenring, Stephen Fleischer, Norman Gordon, John Garfield, and Alan Sigaloff, Michelle Avnis, Dan Ginsberg, Dan Rosen, Nancy Krushek, Elaine Klein, Kamini Shaw, Nancy Jorman. These are just a few of the many that we have lost in this past year. Some we've lost whose names we might not have on the screen, but we know that you hold your names in your hearts. So please hear them, see them as we listen to Chava play her beautiful violin. I hope that you saw or heard the names of the people who have given your lives meaning, the people that you have carved out this space to remember.
I hate death. Years coming to know someone, you may become heart to heart, soul to soul with someone. Takes time for that. You begin to melt into each other. We call this love. It's a melting. I melt into you, you melt into me. When you know someone, you may go soul to soul. More than melting, your souls begin to converge. We call this convergence. We become one, something different from each of us. We become one, someone else. This happens with love. That's why I hate death. After melting into each other, convergence, becoming one with each other, I hate death, because after that someone dies, then you have to wait. Thresholding, we call it. We wait on a threshold for each other. That's why I hate death. It's the waiting. This is what we mean when we say we are waiting for God. God is waiting for us. It's code for we are God. We are waiting for each other. We wait. We wait. This is the source of all our hunger. Heart to heart, melting, soul to soul. Convergence, becoming one, death, waiting, the threshold, God. Amen.
Amen. There's a verse from the Song of Songs that we usually speak at weddings. Anila Dodiva Dodili, I am my beloved's and my beloved is mine. On one level, it is about love, but I think it also teaches us that we belong to each other. And it's this belonging that gives meaning to every breath. It is this belonging to each other that also makes us so vulnerable that we can break from our losses. For years, I've taught that the holiday cycle is meant to push us to be ready for the new year, to push us to be ready to wish each other a sweet new year and really mean it, in spite of what we who have had such devastating loss, what we know can happen. The new year is all about renewed hope in a better future. Something new is drawn into the world that rebuilds our trust in ourselves, others, and creation, as imperfect as all of this is. Without awareness and without a practice, we could miss the very opportunity that will give our lives meaning, will help us move forward, and will bring healing to our bruised souls and broken hearts. I believe this still, and I also know it's the new year. And I'm still not ready to let go of my sorrow and my grief, like many of you. And still, I face these holy days, sad and broken, but I do face them, for there is no way to journey through the loss other than to keep going with more love, more depth, more compassion for the suffering of us all. To do this, takes the practice of less self, less asking why us, less holding on to guilt and pain to leave room and expand into something we have not yet imagined. And so we will say the memorial prayers. We will put ourselves in the arms of this tradition. We will have our Yizkor service to carve out this space to remember and pray that the memory of all of these good people that we hold in our hearts will bless our days.
Il male rachamim shochein bamerumim amitzim nocha nechona tachat kanfei hashchina im kiroshim uteodim kezohar arakiyam mazirim v'nishmot יקירנו שהלכו לעולמם בעל הרחמים, יסתיריתם בסתר כנפיך לעולמי, ויצרור ויצרור החיים את נשמתם, אדוני הוא נחלתם, וינוחו בשלום על משכבם, ונאמר, Amen. O God, full of compassion, you dwell in the highest place. Grant perfect rest under the wings of the Shekhinah, with all the holiest and the purest ones who shine like the highest shining of heaven. For our souls, our dearest ones that have gone to the world, so master of giving, protect them forever. May their souls always be bound up with the souls of the living. May their souls always be tied up, bound up with the souls of the living. May the rest be a rest of peace. And let us say, Amen.
Amen. And so we invite you now to say the words of the Kaddish with us. The Kaddish said was brought to us by angels. And so I hope with the music, the poetry, the prayer, the names, that somehow now this prayer that the angels have brought us helps us feel a little closer. The world's a little closer, this world and the world to come, to bring us closer to those we have loved and lost. And so we say together, Yit Kadal V'Yit Kadash Shemei Rabba V'Yom Bat Yivrach Yerute V'Yom Lich Machute V'Chayachon V'Yom Echon V'Chayed Echol B'Yisrael Ba'agala V'Yisvahan Kariv V'Imru Amen Yehei Shemei Rabba Mevarach Le'olam Omei Omaya Yit Barach V'Yishtabach V'Yit Pa'ar V'Yit Ramam V'Yit Nasei V'yit hadar, v'yit talei, v'yit talal, shmei, t'kudasha, b'richu. Le'ela, min kol birchata, b'shirata, tushpachata, b'nechamata, t'amiran be'alma, v'imru, amen. Yehei shloma rabba min shemaya, v'chayim aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael, v'imru, amen. Ose shalom b'mramav, hu ya'ase shalom. Aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael ve'al kol Yoshvei Tevel.
Ve'imru, amen.
Amen. May the source of peace truly bring peace to you who mourn and comfort to those who are bereaved, as we say together. Amen. Do you have this one? Oh, yeah. We have one more poem. One more poem. I want this one. Maybe. Yeah. Okay. So it's a different one. Which is that? What's that?
Smile.
What? Oh, we're gonna do that at the last.
Okay.
Gosh. You know, doing things this way is really, it's challenging. It's challenging not to be there and to see who has come, especially to this holy time and this holy place, who's carved out the space to remember. But there is something that normally is sung. Let me read this and then you'll read your poem. It's we do it a lot, but maybe we should. And I know probably many of you know the words. I see that someone lost their mother, Joy Littman, in April. She is in my prayers. All of the people that, oh my goodness, Beth Herzig says that her father, who died 2 years ago, I think we said his name, remembered his name, his prom date was Ruth Bader Ginsburg. So it just reminds us that every one of those names, every one of the people we hold, has such a story. And so we promise that we will remember them. In the rising of the sun and its going down, say with me, we remember them. In the blowing of the wind and in the chill of winter, say with me, we remember them. In the opening buds and in the rebirth of spring, we'll remember them. In the blueness of the sky and in the warmth of summer, we will remember them. In the rustling of the leaves and in the beauty of autumn, we'll remember them. In the beginning of the year and when it ends, we'll remember them. When we are weary and in need of strength, we'll remember them. When we are lost and sick at heart, we remember them. When we have joys we yearn to share, we remember them. So long as we live, they too shall live. For they are now so much a part of us, and we remember them.
It's a prayer I wrote last night. Erev Yom Kippur evening. I just ate a nice meal before the start of Yom Kippur. I ate some Brussels sprouts and kasha. Kasha is much for nostalgia as taste. Soon we will begin with the holy prayers. By late afternoon tomorrow, no, I will have had enough prayers. By then I will not have eaten in almost 24 hours, and I take some medicines, thus I begin visions. I will also be done with prayers. Only one I am left with by the time we get to Yizkor. There are more prayers before the day concludes, but for me, this may be the last prayer of the day. Three words in Hebrew. Baruch Dayan Ha'emet. Three words in English. We miss you. Can we do this?
Yeah. So how do we end? Oseh shalom b'mermav. Uyaseh shalom. The last line of the Kaddish, that's a prayer for peace. Prayer that is meant to draw holiness down, to comfort us, to fill the spaces between us. But I think we have something better, something, a gift for all of you.
Though your heart is aching, smile even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you get by. You smile through your fear and sorrow. Smile maybe tomorrow. You see the sun come shining through for you. Light up your face with gladness. Hide every trace of sadness. Although a tear may be ever so near, that's a time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you just clouds in the sky, you get by. If you smile through your fear and sorrow, smile maybe tomorrow. You see the sun come shining.
Carved out this space for our grief. Carved out this space to remember. And we'll sit with it for a little bit. And just hold the memories of the people that have given our lives so much meaning. We'll hold them with us. And let them fill the entire space for just a moment. And then we'll go back to our lives. back to this Yom Kippur day that challenges us to take that inventory of our souls, to forgive others if we need to forgive ourselves. Sometimes that's the hardest thing, to forgive ourselves. But that is the work of this day. So hold this space and get ready to expand into something more. So the day continues. You're welcome to stay in the chat room with each other. I think we pick up with meditation at 5:30 or 5:30 and 6, right?
Yes.
And then at 5:30 and 6, there'll be half an hour of reflective times, first with Rabbi Randy and then with Rabbi Jim. And then at 6:45, we'll all come back together and be ready. Be ready after all this work we've done to hear the great Tekiah. As the gates close, we will hear that Tekiah Gedolah and let it signal that we have kept hope alive for a sweeter year, a healthier year, and a year that would take us a little closer to peace. Amen.
Mar Chatima Tov. Those of you who are streaming on Facebook or YouTube, I'm about to turn on that live stream. I invite you to join us on Zoom. And you can go there by going to centralreform.org. At the bottom of your screen, you should see that right now. And you should see a link for the breakout rooms, which we're going to have for the rest of the day. Again, if you were watching this on YouTube or Facebook or on the website, please go to centralreform.org to join the Zoom. We will broadcast Nila on live feed again. So any of the places that you are streaming right now will be live for Nila. But the rest of the breakout rooms are going to be much more intimate and much more personal. And so we are not going to be live streaming those, but we would love for you to join us. Gemar Chatima Tova, everyone.
Thanks for joining us.